Hi, welcome to my lab. This is a vertical gyroscope, model 314. This model was installed in the Boeing 737 and probably other aircrafts also. This is a large instrument. So this is a delicate instrument, of course. On that side, there are two connectors. I have found on internet some pictures of this kind of instrument, and some of them doesn't have this left connector. The reference of the model with the single connector is 311, so I don't know the purpose of this connector. So this thing is secured, as you can see. So first I will do a teardown of this instrument, and after that I will see if it is possible to connect this gyroscope to an attitude indicator. So this gyroscope is vertical, that means that the axis of rotation is vertical, like this. So this permits the measurement of movement in that direction, which is the pitch, and also in that direction, which is the roll. First, let's open this thing to see what is inside. This is a beautiful piece of mechanical stuff. So the gyroscope itself is inside this central part here. This is the outer gimbal, and this one is the inner gimbal. Everything is perfectly balanced, as you can see. You can see the circular contacts here. You can notice also these contacts here, which permits to have two informations depending on these two angles. We have the same on the other gimbal here. The measurement is performed by these coils here, so this is a kind of synchro resolver, probably. I'll try to zoom in. Okay, we can see that there are 5 contacts, probably. Yes, okay. And on the other axis, it is difficult to see, maybe here. Okay, so we can see that we have also the same number of contacts here. It's difficult to see. We can see the contacts of the coils. So first, let's try to supply this thing. I have found on internet only one picture of this thing with a pinout of the power supply. So the only information I have is the terminals to be used for the power supply. So this is number 1 and 44 on this large connector here. I will connect the power supply. You can see my previous video if you want to see how the power supply is performed. Okay, the power supply is on. Okay, I think that the velocity is stabilized. Okay, and you can see the effect of the precession of the gyroscope. When you apply a torque in that direction, you have actually a torque which is applied in a direction which is 90 degrees apart from that direction, depending on the rotation of the gyroscope. So you can see that the torque is applied in that direction, the spinning direction clockwise. Okay, the power supply is turned off now. And you can see the perfect balance of this thing. I think it will take several minutes to stop, probably. You can see that we have another coil on the other side here. You can see this coil here. So this thing permits to adjust the balance of this thing by changing the position of this mass from the center here. And there are also this thing which permits also the correction, and there is this screw. So let's have a look on the electronic side now. This is an old school technique. So there is one PCB here. And we have two electronic boards. I don't know if we can call it board, but this interconnection plate with the Teflon standoffs here. Oh, okay, this is very nice and very complicated design, you can see. You can see these very nice capacitors. The dead code is probably 86, it seems, yes, probably 85 for this one. Let's have a look on the PCB itself. I will try to orientate this thing in order to see something on the camera. So this is obviously a power supply. We have a transistor here with obscure reference. Dead code 85. And there are several diodes, filtering capacitors. And on this PCB, there are classic parts of transistors, a few op-amps. It is difficult to see and absolutely impossible to remove. And we can see that we have another very nice capacitor here. You can see this one here. So I don't know the purpose of this one, on this thing, of course. I would like to find the documentation, but this seems very difficult to find. Because without documentation, I'm not sure that it should be possible to understand how this thing works exactly.